I've arrived in Frankfurt. I'm in the Airbnb all by myself, waiting for Koli and Nonji to get here. The layout of this Airbnb is a little bit strange, admittedly, but let me take you on a tour.
Okay, when you walk in the front door, there's a big mirror here in front of a cupboard. So that's where we can hang some of our stuff. And then when you go to the left of the front door, there is a room with a double bed. So pretty cool, pretty private. And then when you walk this way, there is our bathroom. So we have towel warmers and fresh towels, toilet basin, sink, all the rest of it, some toilet paper, and also some hand wash. Not sure if there's anything. Oh, more towels. Okay, that's cool. And then when you walk this way, there is a single bed, a dining room table of sorts, as well as another single bed, a fan, because it's actually quite hot in this apartment in general. And then we have a TV. When you walk over here, we have our kitchen set up. So sink, stove, microwave, toaster, kettle, anything you want really, even a washing machine. So just gonna see what's in the cupboards. Oh, there's coffee, there's creamer, a little bit of oil. Ah, it's so nice when Airbnbs take the time to actually give you some of the things and don't expect you to start from actual complete scratch. We have glasses. There's also some plates and stuff. And then I don't know how to open this. That's fine. Forks, knives, the rest of it. We have pots and more pots, so we can make all the eggs in the world that we want. This cupboard, I'm not sure is even, oh, it is. It has cleaning stuff. So yeah, see, we even got dishwashing liquid so that we can actually do our dishes. I wonder if there's anything in the fridge. Ah, iced tea. Must be from the people who previously stayed here because it looks like it's for kids. And then a freezer. So, pretty cool place. It's pretty central. It did not take me long to get here. It's like 5 minutes away from the train station. So yeah, time for our adventure in Frankfurt.
I've just got back from buying every red light I could find, like the different brands, especially the ones that I haven't tried, because I'd like to take the girls on my red light tasting journey with me. So I've got Engel red light. I've got Natur red light, but they're all called Natur red light, so I'm not sure. And then I also have Rhone Radler and Grosser Radler. I've actually tasted this one. It was the first one I had. And then this guy gave me two. And Bio Radler, which I guess is natural ingredients. Wada wada. So yeah, waiting for them to get here and then we can do tasting. Having been outside, I can't help but notice how different it is here compared to Munich. Like here, it's like there's no order. So I was a little bit confused on whether it's even a safe place to live. So I Googled, is Offenbach safe? And actually I wrote, is it Offenbach? And then the first thing that came up was, is it safe? So I got a little bit concerned. And then the first thing that comes up is like crime statistics. I was like, what the hell? And then I actually went to a Reddit post where someone asked if it's safe, and it's a recent post. And I read through some of the comments, and some of the comments are really positive. So I'm not so worried anymore. But yeah, that was a bit of a wake-up call, because I'm just realizing we didn't really research the area before we booked this Airbnb. We go round in circles, round in circles.
world goes searching for love. We go up and down, lost and found, searching for love. Looking for something that lives inside me.
I had one bad experience with Apple in Thailand in 2019, and then I wrote it off for the rest of my life. But now I'm back, and it is a drink. It's our second day in Frankfurt, and last actually. I couldn't talk when I was hungry, so I can talk now. But I'm full and a little bit tipsy because we had Aperol spritz, which were amazing. Now we're going to the mall. I'm not sure how we're getting there. Oh well, I know how we're getting there, the train. I don't know. We're gonna go look for stuff for the Beyonce concert, and then we're gonna start getting ready.
I'm building my own foundation. Yeah. Oh, like, oh baby, baby, you won't break my soul. You won't break my soul.
I think we found our way to the city center, and now we're looking for Primark to do the shopping that we want to do. It's very busy here, and there's a lot of stores that we recognize, which is cool. So I think we found, you know, like where the VIB place is. It's near Konstablerwach station. So now, shame, we wish we were staying closer to here, because we definitely could have found a vibe every day, but it is what it is. So yeah, let's go do our shopping, and then we need to start heading back so we can get ready for Beyonce. Fighting for our lives with the train system again, but it should be here in 6 minutes if they want, because sometimes it says 6 and then it says 5 and then it says 6 again, so we're not sure. But it's hot and we're sweating. But we're cute, but we're sweating. So waiting until the train comes, and at least it's the last one that we get there.
So close to the city.